And it's a 10-point must-win system, which is used on the WSB. And for those of you who may be new to that, essentially whoever wins the round must win 10 points. Now, if it's a close round, it's scored 10-9. If there's a clear winner with dominance, it's scored 10-8. And if there's total dominance, it can be scored 10-7. And if the fight is overmatched, then it's 10-6. The first fight will be in the light flyweight category. Junior Leandro Zarate up against Ovidio Bursino. Now, Ovidio has a 0-1 record on the WSB. And he's ranked 18th up against Zarate, who it's his debut, but he does have a decent background, as I mentioned earlier. 2008 national champion and 2010 Pan American Games silver medalist. So, a lot expected of him. So makes his way to the ring. Ovidio Bursino. Team Germany, teams dispensing with the anthems for this clash. Bursino weighed in at 48.9 kilograms, just 0.1. The maximum, 49 kilos, category 46 to 49 in light flyweight. His loss came in week 8, and that was at home against Italia Thunder's Mark Anthony Barriga, ranked 3rd. Barriga has only had 2 fights this season, and he beat Bursino. He also beat Leandro Blanc in week 6. That's for Argentina. So out to the ring now comes Junior Leandro Zarate, 24 years of age. He weighed in at 48.8 kilos. So hardly anything between the two boxers. Five judges around the ring, and the computer randomly selects 3 of the 5 scores given at the end of each round. There's a confirmation of Dosunmu's record this season and his rank at 18. The fact that he does have experience may count in his favour, even though it was a losing one. Getting his official introduction. And Junior Zarate having his first World Series of boxing, is pure boxing at his absolute best. The bringing and coming together of amateurs and professionals alike, all competing under the WSB banner. Judges from Ecuador, Canada, Brazil, Hungary and France will also come into the ring, and referee as well. The final exchange of pleasantries before we get this first round underway of a scheduled 5 in the light flyweight category. Go. Zarate in the blue shorts, Bersino in the black. Argentina combos against the German Eagles. As you might expect, a fiery start from both boxers. Looking to impress early on. We'll be looking at a number of things over the course of the bout in order to determine which boxer gets that last win, 10 points. A number of quality blows landed in the target area is key. Also, domination of the bout, competitiveness, technique and tactics superiority. And of course, the infringement of the rules, which will count against the boxer. So Lante looking very composed for his first WSB fight. Blows. Colley now doing his job and got his defences up. His opportunity. Referee to have done so far in this first round. Both boxers keen to get on with that, just the boxing, a little holding. The last few seconds of the first round. Between the two fighters. Both camps will be pleased with the way that one went. We're up to the judges to decide who took it. So we have a look at a few highlights from that first round. So a little bit hit and miss from both boxers. There's some good quality punches in there. Notably that one from Bussanau. You don't have to be from the country that you are fighting for on the WSB, you have to be registered with the Federation. It's Ovidiu Bersenau, who is Romanian, eligible to fight because he's registered with the German Eagle franchise. Currently top of Group A are the Italia Thunder. The Ukraine Ottomans are second. Team Germany are in third place, and it's the USA Knockouts holding the last playoff position. And Algeria Desert Hawks and Argentina Condors cannot qualify as we get round two underway. But certainly, as far as the Condors are concerned, they want to finish on a high and move above the Desert Hawks. Zarate. Technical issue. This is the protector coming undone. That's really good. Time back on the clock, and away they go again. And there's something for home fans to start cheering about. Zarate getting involved, and that's now giving as good as he gets. Both athletes. Well, if he didn't call break, as a result, the reason why Zarate couldn't be throwing punches is Cristiano backed off him. And ferocity of the punches. Will that change though as we hit round four and five? Zarate with a wild right, which Cristiano is able to evade very easily. Zarate. There's no advantage for either boxer in terms of height and reach. Both evenly matched. It is an evenly matched contest at the moment. Very little to choose between them. Round two comes to an end. The home fans enjoyed that. Applause for their man. The judges made of it. That's the important thing. Great right from Zarate catching Luciano, and again. Equally though, getting as good as he got. Then the scheduled five is on the defensive. So many punches thrown by both boxers, the percentage of which actually connect has not been that high in this round so far. Zarate, body blows from him, watching Cristiano down low, and then deciding to go upstairs. Just warning Cristiano about that inside hand. He's now clean punches, not allowed to use the palm of your hand to strike your opponent. Being warned about the holding. a sign that Antonio's getting a little bit tired. So that's it. Seems to be going at the same speed he did in round one. Same level of intensity. And he's taking the fight to Bersiano in this third round. It's up to Bersiano to respond. This is too quick for him at the moment. Sensing an opportunity, the crowd enjoying what they're seeing. No reason at all for him to back off. The referee saying get on with it. Zanate, maybe he heard something. There was no bell, but there is now. You're allowed just to turn away from your opponent. For no reason. Zanate taking as much air as he can. Zarez hosting this encounter for the Condors against the Eagles, and they'll be hosting the 2018 Youth Olympics as they took the baton over from Nanjing in China. So this is how things have gone as far as round three is concerned. Zarate taking it 10-9. Just enough at the moment. Persianu knows that he is going to have to now take this to Zarate. A huge left. Zarate easily evading that one. But trying to swat a fly, these two. Equally difficult to land punches on. Take a punch to give a punch. To get off the ropes, get back in the centre. Still, both boxers pretty light on their feet. Zarate sensing an opportunity. Deciding now is the time for him. The last 50 seconds. It's the first time Zarate's actually gone in, looking to hold on to this. Yeah, that's better from him. Straight away, the crowd appreciating that left from Zarate. Couple of wild swings from Vercianu. Fast footwork from Zarate, happening to evade Vecchiano's onslaught. Another good round for the Condors. From Zarate. He's able to keep his distance well. One of the judges went in favour of Vercianu, but two in favour of Zarate. For an interesting final round. Vecchiano straight away out of the blocks firing. Psychological predicament for both boxers. Zarate in his debut wants a win. Vecchiano in his second fight looking for the win. And there will be a winner. Who is it going to be? Again, flurry of punches from both boxers. Defensive position firing, and he's been told again, using the palm of his hand to cuff Zarate. That's clean punches only. Taking it to Vecchiano. Zarate finishing the fight as he started it. There has been no loss of speed really from him or intensity. To Vecchiano, he too has fought just as hard as he did in round one. Is feeling it. And certainly Vecchiano feeling those. As he comes on the counter now at Zarate. Last few seconds of this final round. And that's it. The fight's over. Has Zarate done enough? Paper looked like it would be a fairly even contest, and it proved to be just that, didn't it, over the course of the five rounds. no one dominated particularly. So it's up to the judges to decide who's done enough. Although that look from Bursianu says he doesn't feel he probably has. Descends as we await the official announcement. Zarate takes the bout in the first fight of the evening, goes the way of the home fans. They're delighted. And the home team very happy. Points win then for Leandro Zarate in his debut on the WSB. And that makes it 1-0 to the Condors. Final scores. It was only the Ecuadorian who was in favour of Bursianu, but only for one round. Otherwise, it was Zarate who took it. Winning each round as a result. So light flyweight is done and dusted. And that means now we move on to the bantamweight, which is over 52 up to 56 kilograms.